Hello! In today's Watch Mojo video, we're gonna see the 10 reasons why the new Clone High reboot doesn't work. Reason number one, Gandhi isn't here. That's the end of the list. Goodbye. Hi guys, how you doing? Welcome back. Today we're going to talk about C, and I was going to title this video C, the show that nobody saw, because I thought that was funny because I'm dumb. But apparently while C was on air, I mean was streaming, it was the most watched Apple TV on Apple TV. Except I literally don't know anybody who's seen C. There's gonna be a lot of these jokes on this video. It's gonna be good. But like, the premise is so awesome. Plus, it was Jason Momoa. And it was Jason Momoa back when Jason Momoa was like the talk. Like, it was the actor that everybody was like thirsting over. So it didn't make sense to me. And I love this show. And I was, every week I waited for a new episode, even though I knew that the season was over. And then there was the whole COVID thing that made it, you know, yeah, and stuff. COVID ruined everything. Today, I'm just gonna see what made C not only great, what made it not be as impactful as Game of Thrones. Because I've heard people call Jason Momoa Bubba Voss. That's how impactful that the series was. But they don't even know where it's from. I genuinely know people that think that Bubba Voss was his nickname from Game of Thrones. Anyways, just a recap of the show. Just so you don't know,
here's gonna be spoilers.
So, IMDb describes the show. C is a show where far in the distant future, the human race has lost all sense of sight. Society has had to find new ways to interact, build, hunt, and survive. Basically, it's a post-apocalyptic future. It's not the thing with Pablo Pascal. It's not The Last of Us. It's like way, way farther in the future where like society just had to re-evolve back to basically caveman times because they tried to solve global warming, but then it created a virus that made everybody blind. And it starred, of course, the Bubba Voss, Jason Momoa, and his kids. There is, wait. Margaret Kane, played by Hera Hilmar. That is a name. Okay, what am I complaining? Mine even stranger. There is Hanoa, played by Nesta Cooper. And then there's Kofun, or as we call it, as we call him, Little Boy, played by the incredible Archie Madekwe. I really hope I pronounced that name correct. And he was in Midsummer, right? Yeah, he was in Midsummer. He was one of the guys in Midsummer, because I remember, I'm like, oh yeah, he was in Midsummer. And then he's gonna be in Gran Turismo, which I've seen the trailers for, but I don't know, man. I don't know. I'm
sorry.
I'm clipping a lot. I don't know why. Let me fix it. Okay, all right. I really hope I fixed the problem. Okay, seems good. Okay, so I was saying, Little Boy, Kofun, we hate him. Okay, if you like him, it's fine. He's fine. He's okay. I don't know. He's that one character in the series that just does every bad decision every single time. You should watch the show. I'm not gonna spoil like the big parts of the show for you, just so that you can go watch it. But it's amazing. It's amazing how just wrong he is every single time. So the series was pretty cool. The action choreography in this movie are, and I dare to say, just as good as John Wick. There's three movies that I actually like their action choreographies. There's John Wick, there's Bombshell, which is made by basically the same people that did John Wick, and there's this series. It is so good how they find the way to like use the world of people using every single sense they have except for sight to be able to fight. It is so well done. I can't explain to you how good it. I just want to show you like a fight scene just so you can see how cool it is. But I don't want to get demonetized, so I'm just gonna use something that's on the trailer, probably in the trailer, probably. Like the way that they fight wars, it's just so cool. Like it's insane. The way that they write, the world is really well built. The way that they fight, the way that they read messages, because they have these little knots. When they get messages, it's like a thread that they get with little nods. That's how you read the message. It explains itself. I don't know why I explained it twice. So like, the world is good. The actors are good. The performances are extraordinary. The makeup is... Did I clip again? Stop clipping! Jesus. It's clipping. Stop clipping. The performances are extraordinary. So, and every time I tried to talk about the show to one of my friends, they said, oh, they didn't watch it And I'm like, just get Apple TV, watch the show. And they were like, no. Apple TV was new, nobody wanted to download it for some, or they were pretending like they weren't downloading it, but I'm pretty sure that they did. But it was like the show on Apple TV, because the other shows were, yeah, they were fine. But now, like, Apple has like a bunch of really good stuff. Like, people didn't know what to think of Apple back then. Now we know. However, there were a host of problems that made people not want to really, you know, see the show, even though it was the biggest show on Apple TV. That was basically the problem that the show had. It was the fact that it was on Apple TV, because it was already saturated. The platform, the market was already saturated with Netflix, Amazon Prime, and HBO Max, and now it's Max for some reason. Jesus, go back to Stranger Things, eh? Hehe. With fewer subscribers, fewer people had access to see, which limited the show's reach and the number of people engaging in discussions about it. It became confined to a niche audience, hindering its growth as a cultural phenomenon. Which makes sense, you know? Makes sense. But like, now that Apple has like Severance, and everybody's seen Severance, or I hope you've seen Severance. If you haven't seen Severance, why? It's so good. It's so good. Season 2 is probably gonna suck because of the writer's strike. Let's be fair. Just pay your writers, gosh darn CEOs. That is like the official version of why C didn't really become as popular as Game of Thrones or Star Trek or any other stuff like that. I think it's going to have like a big, very good like fan base that's gonna grow, and like in 10 years they're gonna be like, oh my gosh, why did nobody see C when it came out? They didn't see C, we saw it. my thought in the back of my head for a long time, and it's the reason I wanted to do this video, was I think that the blind community kind of like weren't all the way in. They weren't really into the show. Like, they didn't think it represented them correctly, or that it brought a couple stereotypes that they didn't like, because I know that taking a disability and making it the focus of your show is a very delicate process. A lot of people can get mad very easily. Whether you make it like a superpower or like a hindrance, you have to like tread very lightly. The premise of C is that everybody's blind in the future, right? But what I didn't say is that Jason Momoa and Hanua, was it Hanua? No, wait. No. Yeah, Margra. Jason Momoa and Margra have children, which are Kofun and Hanua. I'm clipping. And they, Hanua and Kofun, were born with sight in a world where nobody wants to see, sees. And apparently, like, their legends and their cultures told them that the world was destroyed previously because of people that could see. Because they had sight, they had too much power, they used it for evil, and then they destroyed the world. And that's why, like, if you find somebody that can see, basically just like, you know what I'm saying? And they're hiding their kid's sight, which is not as easy as you would think in like a world where, like, you know, people are blind, but not like legally blind where they have a little bit of sight, just like totally utterly blind. And I remember when I was writing this video, I wrote in the script, I think the blind community didn't like seeing C. And then I read that sentence like 3-5 times. I thought there was something wrong with that sentence. I couldn't figure out what. And then I'm like, Stefan, you're so dumb. Blind people can't see. And then after doing research on this show, I actually learned that there's actually different types of blindness and different levels of blindness. And there's like a strong community of blind people that saw C, legally blind people. And this article that I found that came out when the show, like, I think the day that the series premiered, because I see that the article is from, where is it from? 2019? So that was a while ago. Remember? Pre-pandemic? Oh my gosh. We were so young. So young. Okay. The article is literally called Treading Carefully with New Blindness Drama C. It gives a recap of the series that I already did for you, so I'm not gonna read again. But the part that is important is where it says, after seeing the first episode, we wondered why the blind people of the new world, who are clearly competent and capable of organization and concerted action, I don't know what concerted means, sorry, French speaker, native French speaker, are unable to build a technologically advanced civilization full of accessible gadgets. The thing with that phrase is that if he had actually understood the dystopian aspect of the story, he would have understood, and this is my die-hard nerd fan brain coming out right now, is that they weren't able to build a technologically advanced civilization, not because they were blind, but because they were f***ing afraid of technology. Like, they're scared of it. Because they basically think that technology destroyed the world, which is true. So they just said, okay, let's not build any more technology. Though that's why there's no technology. The blindness aspect doesn't have that much to do with it. I mean, they build societies around, like, ancient structures like dams and warehouses and abandoned, like, suburbs or garages and stuff. But it's like, this is for the land, and we shouldn't do anything more with that than just the thing for the land. There is obviously, like, different levels of civilizations. If you watch the show, you'll get it. But technologically, is technology bad? Seeing bad. That is what the show is trying to. It's the 2 points that the show is trying to show us. We also wondered about the purpose of introducing sighted characters into the story, who some of the blind characters seem to view in reverence. That's okay. Reverence, yes, but most of the characters see them as witches, as bad, as because they have the sight, and the sight is like a curse, basically, in their world. So they need to get rid of, for example, okay, so I'm gonna spoil the series just a little bit, just a little tiny bit for you guys. So Kofun and what's her name? I'm sorry. So Kofun and Hanua, they're not Baba Voss's real kids. They're Margra's kids, and Margra did the deed with, where's the guy? Where is he? Oh my gosh. I can't find him. Oh no, that's bad. Oh, that's bad. Okay, so she did the do with this guy. I'm gonna show it here. I forgot his name, and it is not in the cast list. I don't know why. And he could see. He could secretly see, and Margra fell in love with him. But then he ran away, and Margra basically ran away too, because, like, she knew that her kids were gonna be sighted, and she was scared for them, so she didn't want to stay in her kingdom, right? Oh, also, Margra is secretly a queen. A princess. Her sister, Queen Kane, who is terrified. You should be afraid of this lady. Is the queen. She's the queen. Go, queen. Yes, queen. Nobody says that. The queen doesn't like sighted, but not for the reasons that you think she does. She doesn't like sighted people that aren't her babies. She wants babies that can see, because there's, like, a prophecy that sighted are gonna come back. They're gonna come back, and they're gonna change the world, and blah, blah, blah. There's a prophecy. It's like, there's a prophecy. Oh, somebody 1,000 years ago said that this was gonna happen, and then people just interpreted it as a prophecy. It's not like a literal magic. There's no magic in this world. Yeah. Which is cool. The no magic aspect is so good. So she's basically hunting her nephews. The thing is, she doesn't know, because she has a decree that every sighted person is a witch, you should kill them. And everybody's okay with that. So she just thinks that they're random people, blah, blah, blah. Of course, she finds out, and, like, she's like, oh, okay, that's good family. So she can control them inside and take over the world, because the prophecy basically says that sighted people are gonna come back and take over the world, and nobody wants that. So that's the story. The story is great. It's basically being Game of Thrones. It's not really Game of Thrones. With cool fight scenes, with dystopian future, with nature, with, like, people with that have, like, incredible abilities, even though in this non-sighted society. It's cool. It's so good. Every character is good. Also, Dave Bautista is there. Dave Bautista is in the series. He's really good. Not gonna spoil the series, like I said, so you can go watch it, because it's so cool. And it's on Apple TV, and I know you have Apple TV, because you've watched Severance. Everybody has watched Severance, so go watch it. That was the criticism, like, when the show just came out. But then I went down this rabbit hole of, okay, maybe blind people didn't really mess with the show, because the show was, like, I don't know, like, portraying blindness as a superpower, which it wasn't. They had a blindness consultant on the show, which is the reason why the show is so good. So that helped a lot. But also, even though most of the actors weren't blind, there was more blind actors on the set than most media in Hollywood. So the representation box was ticked. I'm always wary of representation, because I always feel like it's very shallow and stuff. But also, blind people are actually the ones that helped create the show. I mean, they really helped. They were really supportive. The blind community was pretty happy about the show, because it was really good. It was really well done. It wasn't just a show made to be like, see, blind people, we gave you a show, so you can't complain anymore. No, they actually put time and effort, and it was well written, it was well made, and they actually supported the show a lot. And there's also this interesting, am I clipping again? Oh, come on, stop it. Okay, I'm just gonna keep going. And there's also this interesting reaction from The Blind Life, a very interesting channel you can go subscribe to if you want, that reacts to the show and explains how every single little detail of the world was built very well, especially the way that people fight. Oh my god, it is so good. The fight scenes are so good. It's amazing. You should really watch it just for his fight scenes. Because they're incredible. The way that Baba Voss just uses sound, lure you in, and then just... Oh my god, it's so good. I love it. So, the blind community didn't kill C. Up until now, we still have the fact that people didn't subscribe to Apple, right? But, why didn't nobody talk about it? Because I remember, even when Amazon Prime wasn't really that popular, Invincible came out, people just were talking about Invincible. So I don't get why people weren't talking about C. But there was another issue that might have killed like the hype that C got, right? It was like for every other show back in 2019, the pandemic, because the second season took so long to come that apparently people just forgot that the show existed. It was supposed to come out in like 3-4 months, came out a year later, and the momentum just died. With the absence of new episodes, people's attention shifted to other shows and their ongoing storyline, and the longer the hiatus, the harder it became for C to regain the spotlight. And again, the oversaturation of everything. I think Marvel was finishing up with was Avengers Endgame after 2019? Oh, Avengers Endgame came out in 2019. Okay, so basically it got caught between a rock and a hard place, where it was really good, but Apple TV, nobody wanted to download Apple TV yet because it was brand new, so it couldn't grow that way. So basically the reason that everybody saw C and that nobody talked about how they saw C,
brother,
or how they just had C
saw,
or how C was because of oversaturation and the COVID pandemic. That's it.
So sorry about all the clipping on this video, guys. I just updated my OBS, so I hope that that's gonna help. I just wanted to say that I went on Google, Googled C TV show memes, and I basically found nothing. I could scroll and scroll, and I would find like one thing made by like a marketing team. It's very bad. But I also went on TikTok and looked for like C TikToks, just basically, and it basically just movie reviewers, except there's like one account that's probably a mega fan that did videos, but there's not a lot. For comparison, I searched for Severance TikToks and I kept on scrolling. I had to speed up the video just so it wouldn't look too long, but like there's no one. So for the people that are gonna comment that I saw C, yeah, you and me, I think we're the only ones, buddy. So yeah.
So in conclusion, it's a good show. Go watch it. I'm going to talk about the crazy shirt that I'm wearing right now. It's insane. It's loud, violently loud. I love it. I made it myself. I designed all this myself. And they'll probably say, oh, of course. I mean, that doesn't surprise me. But seriously, I love this shirt. It's insane. It's out. I'm pretty sure it's illegal to have a shirt this loud somewhere. I mean, look at it. It's insane. If this shirt is not the most godless, fatherless behavior shirt that you've ever seen in your life, I haven't done my job right. I started my own brand a year ago, even before I started YouTube, surprisingly so. And I just wanted to do insane stuff. I got a decent amount of sales, not anything crazy, and we had to close it because of other reasons. I got a job, and then my dad basically saw that I wasn't, you know, drawing anymore, and he kind of got sad, and he said, if you want to reopen your business, I can help you this time, because last time he didn't want to help me, thought that it was just like a phase or something. So I did reopen the business, and I'm very like, I just do literally artistic thing that comes into my head. Right now, the pieces on the site are basic pieces because we wanted to start off light. We didn't want to go too hard, too fast, except for this one. This one goes hard. Oh, it goes hard. So our most sold shirt is this one, the Thunder Thighs shirt. It's apparently the favorite. You're gonna see a running theme of this. This cat is my logo. Her name is Nikki. And also, you probably noticed that I was drawing her in this green screen right here. The story is, Nikki's a cat that wants to become human and goes under body modifications to do so. And she's basically a cat wearing a cat mask, helmet, or whatever you want to call it, on her face because she doesn't like the way that she looks because she's insecure. Everybody asks me, why is her head shaped like that? I'm like, it's a mask. So don't ask me that question anymore. This is the trucker cap that I designed. Everything on the store is is designed by me, and I'm finally getting the support that I need to like start this, because we've been for the past 2 years, actually for the past 10 to 15 years, we've been in like a very unstable financial situation. Living in a third world country and finally coming to the US kind of like fixed a lot for us. And now I finally, you know, get the support to be able to do the things that I want artistically, even though, you know, I still have to go to work and stuff. And these are the socks. The store is called Mixed Feelings. And then these are the shoes that I made.
So if you've seen one of my older videos, I drew these Crocs live, not live, but on video. There they are. The samples finally arrived. And I put some gibbets on them. I'm finally done editing this terribly horrible video to edit because of all the clipping, and I have these suckers on.
Like it, I'm going to design like some skate shoes because I found a place that lets me design skate shoes. So I'm really excited. I've been wanting to do that for the past 8 years, and I'm really starting because I've done it for the past 8 years, except every time I did it, it failed. Again and again and again, and I'm finally getting to a place where it actually might work this time, and I'm actually, you know, people actually seeing my stuff and actually liking it. And even though my Instagram is basically dead, because didn't really need it for the sales, I don't know how that worked out, but yeah. So I'm just gonna draw for every single video. I have a lot of stuff coming out. We have the spring season coming, and I want to do stuff for that. So this green screen is gonna show everything that I'm doing right here, baby. Yeah. Thanks for watching this video that you watched with your eyes. Peace. My next video is gonna be about the first blockbuster movie that's AI generated after the writer's strike. So that's gonna be interesting. And no, it's not Transformers. So subscribe for that. Just stay tuned for that. Okay, so what else do people say in outros? I mean, I already said peace. I mean, you have to choose another video right now. You probably already chose it and you're not even listening to this. I don't really know what I'm doing this for. I have a lot of free time, I guess. No, I need to go to work. What am I talking about? Jesus. Yeah. What time is it?